Hello and welcome to Scrapping on the Fly. My name is Kristen and I am here with a celebration hop for Scrappy Kia, who has hit 1,000 subscribers. It's her birthday on top of that. So I pulled these three layouts because I thought they were wonderful. It was hard to choose, but since I was trying to go for a back to school or some kind of a school layout, I had three pictures I wanted to document, so I thought these three were the best options for me to scrap lift. And I decided I would go with this one on the top, the yellow one, and I'm going to use this Simple Stories School Life collection. And she works for the school system, and so she said that that would be a great way to honor and support her, is to use something along those lines. So I have plenty of back to school pictures. I am documenting 2012 through 2017. So these pictures are from 2016, and I am using a yellow paper similar to what she used as well. And I have the some collection items from this school life, and then I have this Jolie's by You, the Sticko, and then these two stick abilities. I don't use those two, spoiler alert. So I am hoping to get these pictures documented and celebrate with Scrappy Kia. So I have my paper, my embellishments, my pictures, and this awesome layout. So let's see how this goes. So first things first, like I said, I am using yellow paper just like her in the layout that I selected. Now mine has a like alarm clocks, a school bus, a book, pen, you know, different icons in the background, but it's tone on tone, so it's not in your face. And then I selected this white paper that has these paper clips all over it so that all the color from the frames that I'm going to use will stand out really well. And so these are some of my favorite pictures because this year was the first year all four of our kids, these are my children and my sister's kids. And it is my son and her son are the same age. My daughter and her daughter are the same age. And this particular year, the boys were at the same school, which they were all through elementary. And the girls were at the same school, which had not happened since fifth grade. So this is ninth grade and second grade. And so my sister would come to my house, drop off her son, and pick up my daughter. And so she worked at the school where my daughter and my niece went and would take them. And then I would drop the boys off. Actually, I'd walk them to school. I drove them part of the way and walked the rest of the way. And so we had a really lovely time getting to spend that time together. And so that is how we all got pictures taken together. Now, this particular year is the year that I started working in the school system as well, which was super exciting. And so I had a first day of school outfit like they did. So I'll do another layout at some point for that. So her edges are distressed on this inside piece of paper. And I felt like there was about an inch and a half or so of a border on her layout. So I went with cutting this paper to a 9.5 by 9.5. And I laid out my frames to get an idea for how much space they would take across the layout so that I can have them coming off the edge a little of that paper, which is how her layout is as well. Except hers, of course, are going straight across. Mine is going to be tilted a little because of the way that frame from this collection is connected. But I love the way that these looked, and I was excited that they were going to work for these pictures. So I went ahead and with it. Plus, that first one says first day, and it is the first day of school. So I picked the background, or the backside of that paperclip paper, is that teal with the different office / school supplies on it. So I cut a like 2 inch or 1 3/4 inch piece of that. And then I cut one of the rulers from this paper out, and I used those as my border. And so, or on these little borders up here at the top. And then I'm going to use that space up there to create the title. Now, on her layout, she has a beautiful word in cursive right in the middle on one of those strips. Mine is going to be a little bit over, and that I'm okay with that. Or you can call this like 92 different things. There's a lot of words on this layout when I'm done. So I'm trying to figure out where I want to put everything that I have pulled out. The big thing for these pictures was, to me, you know, it's the first day of school, you're styling, you're looking really good. So that was more what I was going for, not necessarily the educational aspect of going to school. That will be in later layouts, I'm sure. But so I wanted to use this shirt that says Don't Kill My Vibe, because they're all dressed up and looking super cute. And I wanted to use some different word phrases. I considered this one right here that says prepare to be schooled, but it didn't work for me. It wasn't standing out up there, and I could have inked around it, but I don't want to do that. Instead, I pull out from the ephemera or the bits and pieces, I pull out this stack of books or this, you know, line of books. And I guess you could put this down any way you wanted, like standing straight up so it was like a pile of books or like this. And so that is what I did. I put it similar to the way they are in that frame. And so I'm going to tack that down there, and I'm going to put this Every Day I'm Hustling as my title. Now, I do bring in a sticker in a few minutes that says Back to School, and I put that kind of where the title was on the layout. So I guess you could title it that or First Day, really Every Day I'm Hustling was kind of where I was going. So I have now gone through the Jolies and the Sticko Puffies and put down what I liked and wanted to use, as well as the School Life stickers from this 12x12 sticker sheet. And they're over there on that acetate piece. And so I'd like to incorporate all of those things on this layout. And I was excited because the little apple that you see over there matches the apple quite well that's attached to this collection. So that made me happy because I always like to add a little apple on school layouts. I think that's pretty typical, or at least it is for me. So I am just working on putting things down where I want them. I've put a little paper clip up at the top and a little tack pin, just as a couple little extra things to add in for the cluster. She had a really pretty flower up there. And of course, since I'm not doing a pretty flowery layout, I'm using the school supplies. And then down at the bottom by that shirt, I've tucked in a couple of different shoes, because like I said, I'm kind of focusing on how they're dressed up and snazzy. But I also put a little pencil, paperclip, and a backpack over there. And then I'm going to put my word phrases down here as well. She has a journaling space where I have that shirt. So instead, I put the little words, phrases that say, look at this, let's do this, all smiles and school rules, down below that middle picture. And then I decided I wanted to use these very small stickability stickers, because I had a 2 and I had a 9, because that's the grade they were in. And I picked black because I thought it would stand out best. Plus, there's like the little glasses on that one frame that are black. But then, of course, you know, the frame that the boys' picture is in is dark blue. So I decided I would put it on that little apple right there. I considered putting it on the backpack and then putting the year on that apple, but I'm going to stamp the date on here probably later. So that is it. I am so excited for Scrappy Kia. I hope that you all will go and check out her Facebook or her YouTube and her Instagram. That'll all be linked below. I also hope that you will go and check out all the other people who are hopping along to celebrate not only her birthday and her 1,000 subscribers. And I always love to celebrate those who work in the school system. So it's just like a triple whammy for me. And I got another layout done. So I hope that you'll go check all that out. I also would love it if you all would comment below, like, subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope you'll come back and see me again tomorrow. I'll be here every day this month. And hopefully this year, we'll see how that goes. So I hope that you all have a fantastic day. And happy scrapping!